Plot armor is bad, yet many defend it as normal. Such as this guy who sees it as luck. Someone gets lucky enough to survive and win, and the plot becomes us watching how he won. As good as this excuse sounds, it kills the tension. Why would you feel anything about the protagonist when you know he will always win just because he's the protagonist? There should be more than just that for making you care. It should be a case of how he won, instead of he won and the whole show is a flashback. Those who imply plot armor is just coincidences that helped someone to win miss the point of a satisfying story. It shouldn't feel like it's based on luck or coincidences. Nothing happens by luck. Everything in nature happens because of a reason. So when we don't see that reason, it feels artificial. And it's also about the frequency with which it happens. How many coincidences can you tolerate before you stop giving a damn? It's also completely meta-narrative when you think the protagonist needs to keep winning so the plot can keep going. A story that is chained to the constant success of the protagonist is not much of a story, as it is a power fantasy. The world should exist outside of the protagonist's actions, and it should show somehow. Otherwise, it's artificial, because you won't care about what is going on if you know the setting exists as nothing more than a placeholder for the protagonist's achievements. When people complain about plot armor, they mean it more as a privilege and as an unfair advantage. If your protagonist will win and survive no matter what happens, while everyone else fails or dies all the time, then after a certain amount of times it happens, it feels like cheating. You stop caring about him because you know the outcome, and you want to see more of the other guys and what they are doing, because that's where all the tension and the suspense are at, since their outcomes are not predetermined. Let me give you a very simple example from board games. Snakes and Ladders is a very boring game, while Backgammon is one of the most popular games. Although both games are about using dice rolls and moving around pieces on the board, the fundamental difference they have is the amount of things you can do in them. In Snakes and Ladders, you have no control over what you can do. You only have one pion and one die. In Backgammon, you have 15 checkers and 2 dice, and that gives you a lot of options. There is no single checker that is more important than the rest, and even if one of them gets captured, the game keeps going because you can still use the other ones. That's what the absence of plot armor is like. It's not just luck, or one guy doing everything. It's luck combined with tactics where nobody's hoarding all the attention, nobody wins all the time, and nobody survives no matter what.